we are jumping into today's topic. What do I have for you today? Okay. So there is a reason why I always call you guys leaders when I address you, okay? In the community, you are my leaders, okay? I want India to have leaders like you. You all have that mindset, that capability, that potential, and the will also, okay? Which is very, very important. So what kind of mindset should a leader have is what we are going to talk about today. Okay, so basically we will be discussing the mindset, the types of mindset, the actions that we have to take, and how to shift if you are in a different mindset. Okay, so let's jump into the mindset that we are talking about. And why we are talking about mindset. So we, in the course, we are learning about growth mindset and fixed mindset. Okay. Now, there is an extension to this. That extension is what we are going to talk about now. Everything that is happening with you right now, the way you are looking, the way you are thinking, the way you are progressing in your life, the way you are feeling inside your body with, physical and mental, everything is decided by how you think. It is completely coming from your mindset. Okay, so 80% of your success is coming from your mindset and only 20% from the other things that you are doing actually. Thus, we have to be very, very clear about the kind of mindset we have. If we do not have the right mindset, we will jump to the right mindset. Okay, because your mindset radically affect your course of life. Radically, okay, that's the word here. And how you're thinking, because your mindset is actually going to give you the thoughts that you get. So how your thinking is affected. See, your mindset and the way you think will affect your learning. Are you ready to learn? What sort of learning are you getting? How much are you absorbing from the learning? Then it will affect your stress management. Okay, are you somebody who feels stressed really very easily, or are you somebody who is always stress-free? Okay, and if at all you are feeling stressed, then how are you managing it? It is all coming from your mindset. Then how are you creating success for yourself? That also depends upon your mindset. If your mind says that, no, I don't think I can do that, then you will never get success. If your mind says that, no, nobody can stop me and I am going to get it, then that is, just a second, DC, please switch off the AC, please. Okay, so your success, whatever success is created, as we all know that everything that is happening with us is happening here first, in our minds first. We think about it, we visualize about it, and then only it takes the shape of reality. And then resilience building, we have to become, all of us have to become quite resilient towards things happening around us. Okay, so our mindset also helps in resilience building. And then immune system. In our body also, whatever is happening, if I'm feeling some kind of problem in my body, if I'm feeling some kind of a pain, and if I keep thinking, oh my God, I am good for nothing, you know, I always have this, I'm always weak, I'm always lazy, and I'm this and I'm that. If this is the mindset we are working with, we are going to attract more of it. Okay, so it is impacting our immune system also. So these are some of the reasons why we need to really, really work upon our mindset. Okay. So now let's see what are the two types of mindset that I want to discuss with you. Other than growth and fixed mindset, this is an extension to it. Okay, you will identify how. So basically, one is scarcity mindset and another is abundance mindset. Once you are done with this, then you will, you know, you will put people into this. You will put yourself also. Okay, I was once into scarcity mindset. Now I am almost into the abundance mindset. There is still little left from that scarcity. I'm really struggling to come out of that. However, you will now identify whether you are in the abundance mindset or whether you are in the scarcity mindset. So what is scarcity mindset? The scarcity mindset says it is basically a belief that there will never be enough. Okay. You are never satisfied and you're not happy most of the time. By saying you, I am not pointing out at you. I mean, people who are there in scarcity mindset, you could be one. I was one. So this is a belief that there will never be enough. And these people play from, you know, place of lack. Okay, so the action comes from the place of lack. I do not have this. I am not enough. I cannot afford. I cannot do. You know, I will lose this. I am not getting something. Okay, so there is always a lack of something. So I will not use this because it will get finished. Okay, I will not share my knowledge because other person will get benefited, and what will I do later? Nobody will come to me if I share everything. So this is the scarcity mindset where people think that they will always have scarce of things. Okay, that is one mindset. Now we have the abundance mindset. What are these kind of people thinking? What kind of mindset they have? This is a belief that there is always enough resources and success to share with others. These people are people who say, okay, it's okay, you want to take, I have enough. Resources are enough. I say, you know, honestly, even, you know, if you accumulate the wealth of this planet, every single penny, if you accumulate, and even if you distribute it amongst all the human beings present, equally distribute, you know, that could be done. We all are going to be millionaires. That much money we have on this planet. However, after some time, this money is going to go back to the same people that it has come from. Why? Because people lack mindset to have that money, to control that money, to earn that money, or to, keep a hold of that money. So everything is happening, you know, people deserve what they deserve. I have what I have today because I deserve this much only at this point in time. I have to work more to get more. Okay. So abundance means there is already abundance of everything. All the natural resources are abundantly available. All the monies, all the opportunities, all the learning is abundantly available in this world, in this space. But we will have to identify whether we find it that way, or we are somebody who thinks, you know, no, it is not enough. So these are the two kinds of mindset. Now let's see what kind of actions that these people take. If you are somebody in scarcity mindset, this is what you will say or do. You will say you do not have choice. You know, I never had that choice. You know, what choice did I have? So you always feel that you have no choice, and thus you are doing this. Okay. You compete for available resources. Whatever is available here, you will always want to compete. You know, it should come to me. It should not go to anybody else. You know, what if it goes to somebody else? If that is the mindset that you have right now, then you are suffering from scarcity mindset. Then you fear the unknown. Something has not yet happened with you, but then you keep pondering upon it, and then you keep thinking that, you know, this might happen to me. What if it happens to me? Okay, and we all suffer from this, okay? So fear of unknown is always there when we are in the scarcity mindset. Then you will be jealous of people. Okay, we all are jealous of people at some point in time. You know, I was jealous of people when I was like really small. As I said, you know, I do not come from a very affluent background, and we were always used to have only 3 clothes in a year. Okay, one for my birthday and 2 for Diwali and Dashera, and I craved for clothes. Okay, I loved clothes. Most of the women, most of the girls love clothes a lot, and I always used to dream of, you know, I would wear one dress and I would never ever repeat that dress. So many clothes I should be having. And that was the time when I used to feel jealous of all the other friends who were affluent, who were really rich, and you would, you know, dress up in front of me like a princess and all. So I used to feel jealous. Why? And I used to curse myself. Why am I not having all this? See, that was the time when I was really young. Today, I do not feel like that. I have enough, you know, even if I repeat a couple of clothing, it is okay. I do not care now anymore. Okay, so I am moving to a different mindset now. So it could be jealous, could be, you know, she came first, she has enough, she has more than me. Okay, or he has got that opportunity. Oh my God, he has got the promotion. Why come he has that? Why don't I have? All of this feeling is coming out from our scarcity mindset. Then if you have this mindset, then you are afraid of losing money, people, position, and knowledge also. If I share, so there are, I tell you what, there are so many mentors and coaches all these days, the fake gurus that are coming up. They will never share their knowledge with people. Okay. They will always think that, you know, and there are my people in my fraternity also, they will always say, Sakshi, this is what you have worked for all these years and you are just giving out everything on free webinars. Don't do that. What will you have? Because they feel that they will not have to work. I know I have to work every day to acquire more knowledge so that I can give you more. Okay. So I come from a different mindset. They coming from, not everybody, but few of them are coming from that mindset that they will not share it publicly. Okay. So if you think that, you know, if I give the money out to somebody, what will I do? I will hold that money. I will hold that position. I do not want anybody to come near me. So I will play diplomatically. All this office politics that is happening is because of the scarcity mindset. Then you will fall in false sense of security. If you have certain thing, you will see, you know, this is, you will always try to hold that thing close to you because that is what is giving you security. And you think that if I have this, then only I am secured. If I will have this, then only I will be secure. Okay. So you will invest not in yourself, but in bonds and shares and land and money because you think that is going to give you security. Because basically you are worried, you always lack that security, and by doing and acquiring all of that, you feel a sense of security. Okay, so this is the trait of scarcity mindset. Then people working from this mindset, they usually take poor decisions because they are most of the time fearful of things. Okay, so they tend to take poor decisions. Then also they fear losing if someone else is. Okay, so suppose, you know, just for example, if somebody thinks that, you know, if she has won or if he has won, I have lost. In a competition, of course, I can understand that is okay. If 10 people are participating, one has won and you think that you have lost, that is okay. But otherwise, you know, when you see people growing and doing good in their life, you feel, oh my God, she is a winner and I am a loser. No, there is enough. You have to create that space for your own self. You have to create your own win in your space. Okay. So people with scarcity mindset always feel that, you know, if one person has won, the other person has lost. They do not think about the win-win situation. Okay. Then you are always reluctant of taking chances or risk. These are the people who do not want to change. They just want to be sure of everything. And there is no certainty, no surety of anything in this world. Today I'm talking, I do not know whether I'm going to be seeing the next day. God forbid, Bhagwan. But I'm just saying that you have no guarantee of anything that is happening. So why not take risk and why not take chances and just, you know, go for things. But there are people who would always want to have, you know, if this is right for me or not, does it have these things? Let me try for free. Let me try for this for a couple of days. And then I will make sure whether this is the right thing for me. Come on, if you are not going to try, how are you going to know what is there in it? And then you will decide whether it is right. Once you are done with it, you have learned, and then you will decide, okay, fine, it was for me or it was not for me. But then you have to give your head into that first. Then you think you cannot afford anything. You know, I do not have enough money. No, I cannot manage this. I mean, there's always scarcity. Okay. So you can't get ahead. No, I am this much only. I am limited. I cannot do this. I do not know this. And I can't, you can't have what you, just a second. This is a spelling mistake. Okay, so you can't have what you want. This is what you see. So no, this is just not, this is beyond my limit. I cannot reach that place. I cannot have a big bungalow. I cannot afford a car. I cannot afford a TV. I cannot afford to travel outside. No, I have this much. So this is that middle class mentality that has been there since ages. And that is the scarcity mindset. So you have to work on the money relationship also. We will learn that also some other time. So you are basically, people from scarcity mindset are basically focusing on what is not working. This is not working in my life. This is not going, you know, this relationship is not working. This person is not talking to me properly. I am not getting result when I'm doing this. That concept failed. Whatever is not working is the, thing that people are discussing. Those small talks that people are doing, you know. Government is wrong, people are wrong, environment is wrong, parenting is wrong, education is wrong. Everything wrong is what they are talking about and thinking about consistently, and they are extremely negative and pessimist people. Okay. Now, some of these traits are there in all of us. Something or the other, especially, you know, I am not enough. I cannot do this. I'm not good for anything. I'm good for nothing. This is sometime or the other, it comes to most of us. Okay. But now let's see, what is it that these abundance mindset people do? What actions they do? They always think that Always. Okay. So if you are somebody in abundance mindset, you will always say that you have a choice. If not this, then I have something else. If not that, then I have something else. I will find a way is what they always talk or think about. You always see limitless opportunities. There are enough opportunities. I have seen this, you know, I have felt it. I have witnessed it. If this is not working, God will definitely give you something else if you're willing to find. Okay. So people with abundance mindset, they always see opportunities. And those are the people always, you know, come across with opportunities, or opportunities themselves, you know, go to them. Then these are the people who are extremely generous. They are giving people, they are creative, and they are inspirational also. So they are always inspiring other people. They are very, very giving in nature. Whatever they give, they could be that could be, you know, physical help or some sort of kindness or compassion or money or charity, whatever. They are always generous people. Then you embrace change. Okay, so scarcity people, they fear change. Okay, they want to stay in that comfort zone, but these are the people who embrace change. Okay, so COVID is the new normal. The way we are working right now is the new normal. Okay, yes, I have adapted to it. You all have adapted to it, and this is how we are going to work. And this is different, and we are enjoying. Okay, so this is the mindset of abundance. People with abundance mindset, that they always embrace change. Then they have a proactive approach in life. They are not somebody who will wait to fail first and then attempt something, or they will wait for others to, you know, push them to make effort. They are proactive. They know that this is going to come. They are visionaries, actually. So they see ahead of time. So something might happen. Let me prepare before. You know, in advance, let me prepare in advance. So these are proactive people. They take action really quick and fast. Then, just a minute, huh? Learning.
First one of the scarcity needs to be changed too.
Where?
Scarcity, first point, choice, spelling.
Oh my God, where is that? Oh yeah. I am bad at this, huh? Don't laugh at me. I just rush. Kuch bhi likho, fatafat aage badho. Choice, O-I-C-E. Yeah, now it is correct. Thank you. Okay, so... So you have a learning and growth mind, actually, okay? Growth mindset, rather, not just mind. It's growth mindset that you have. So we have learned growth mindset. We or those who have not yet reached that, you will be learning about fixed and growth mindset. So these are the people who are always, you know, ready to learn something. They are basically the beginners, okay? Then you listen actively, you think clearly, and you live happily. That is the basic funda of there. You know, I am always ready to learn. I will take action swiftly, and I will think clearly in my life. There's no ambiguity, as I said, okay? So you know what you have to do in your life. And even if you do not know, you will attempt and then finalize, okay, fine, it was not for me, and it is for me, okay? That is the approach. You are always in the driver's seat. What I mean by this? See, scarcity people, they always play that victim card. Okay, I am victim of this. Oh my God, things are not happening because I am suffering because of him, her, circumstances, situations, environment, government, economy. I am like this. I am poor. I cannot do this. I am helpless. This is what they do. I am what I am because of other people. I am what I am not because of my own deeds, but because of somebody else. So they always try to play victim card. However, people in abundance mindset, they are always running their own cars. They are always in the driver's seat. They say, whatever is happening, I am driving that. I am bringing the result. Good or bad, it is my responsibility. Okay? Then you always show gratitude. The most important thing. Okay, be thankful for what you have. Right now you are sitting in front of me, be thankful for this. I am sitting in AC, in light, tube light. I have a house, I am eating, I am getting good clothes to wear, and I have everything right now in my life. So I may not be Ambani, I do not intend to be Ambani now, anytime close in future. However, I have everything to live a happy life right now. Okay, I have goals, I have dreams, I want to become rich, I want to grow in my life, I have to have a better lifestyle. But whatever I have right now, I have to be thankful for it. For people I have in front of me, for people there that are there in my life, for everything that God has given me. I am breathing. That is the biggest thing that I have in my life right now. So I need to show gratitude every time. You are saved from something, show gratitude. Thank God, Bhagwan Bachalia. Okay, you got some result. Thank you, God. You gave me the result of my hard work. You did not give me the result of hard work. Okay, fine. That means I have to work harder. Not thinking that, you know, I worked so hard, yet I failed. I did not clear that interview. That interviewer is wrong. And, you know, they never give me the feedback. And these people are bad. Whatever, whatever. No. You did not get this opportunity because something else is waiting for you. And you have to work a little harder to get that. That is the abundance mindset. Okay, then you always show gratitude and you can afford everything. This is the mindset. If I have to invest in a course, I afford. If I have to learn something, I afford. If I have to wear something, I afford. If I have to travel someplace, I afford. Whatever I am doing, just not with the with respect to money, but with everything that you are doing, you afford to do that, you afford to get that, and you are you deserve that. Then you are optimistic and you think big. You are always positive. Okay, you always see, okay, fine, if this is not working, maybe something else will work. I will have to find ways. Okay, so and you always think big. There is no small mediocrity there in our lives. There is no small thinking, no small talking. And we are made to live a life that you can, you know, just if you visualize and just close your eyes and you want to think what kind of life I want if I do not have any sort of problem in my life, if I have abundance of everything in my life, what is the life that I want to live? And the picture that you visualize is what you really, really deserve, right? So we are the people with abundance mindset who can think big and who needs to think big. This is our responsibility also. So the difference is clear now, right now in front of you guys. Yep. Making sense so far? You getting it here? We all are suffering from this, no? Both of this. So we all have something from abundance. We all have something from scarcity also. Yeah. Mansi, what is happening to your video? Okay, she's there. No problem. It's okay. Okay, so let's see now how can we... So what according to you... You can unmute yourself now, huh? Just a second. I need some water. Shubhu. Water. So I want your thoughts on whatever you have learned so far. Tell me. Just one, two quick thoughts. What do you think? Catherine, we'll start with you. Tell me.
Ma'am, personally, I am a mashup of both scarcity and abundance mindset. Yeah. I keep on fluctuating. At certain times, I'm okay, I'm positive, but some downfall, I get stuck for some time, then I slowly recover. I need to transform my mindset and get into a more abundance.
Yes, okay. Yes, Tanvi.
I could really relate well with Catherine. Both mindset prevailing at now, but I need to change it to abundance mindset. Mm-hmm.
Vibhuti, what revelation did you have now?
I agree with you that, you know, we fit into both the categories. So it's like actions are afterwards, but first we have to change our mindset.
Yes.
So yes, I match the scarcity points, but yes, I think I need a change in my mindset. Mm-hmm. And I think the most important is that when, you know, you just start blaming others. If it's happening into your life, and you start blaming others. That's easy.
Yes, absolutely.
Yourself. That's so it's like so accepting it and then you can change it. So
that's
that is
awesome. Wonderful input. I love this. I really wanted somebody to say that we all do that. Yes, Shreya, your input.
Yeah, so firstly, I agree to what Vibhuti said just now that we blame others. For example, I recently had a breakup and I was totally shattered. And I said ki I cannot do anything in life. I was totally dependent. And it was like that. So, uske pehle, I was more into the,
abundance mindset.
नो आई वाज इनटू स्कैसिटी माइंडसेट
ओ अच्छा पहले ओके ओके
पहले
या
पर
हाँ
उसके बाद आई रियलाइज कि नाउ आई हैव टू थिंक अबाउट माई सेल्फ बिकॉज समटाइम्स इट हैपेंस दैट व्हेन यू आर इन अ रिलेशनशिप यू टेंड टू फॉरगेट योर सेल्फ नॉट विद एवरीबॉडी बट इट हैपेंस विद
मी यस यस मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इट हैपेंस विद गर्ल्स हां आई टेल यू इट इज राइट
सच के वुडंट एग्री so what happened was after that I started discovering myself and I could actually see the transition from scarcity to abundance and after that I thought of changing my career and everything so I was a cry lone I was a lone wolf I used to cry I was a growth loo everybody used to say but after that I changed myself and now I find myself 50% fit in abundance in just one month
awesome. Awesome, good girl, huh? See that's what I say, you know. Breakups also teach us so many things. Right. Breakups now, are good.
Yeah, now when I miss him or something, I think about the abundance things. Like I want to make a change, I want to do something big. And the thought goes away. The dream
That's
thought
good,
goes
yeah.
away.
Because God wants you to have somebody else in your life, a better person.
Nobody, please, nobody.
Okay. As you wish. Huh? Okay, yes, Neha, thank you so much for sharing that. It was wonderful. Huh? I like your openness so much, Shreya. You know, because it's not, we are not always here to learn. We are here to know each other, learn from each other's experiences also. So thank you for bringing in.
I want to say that everybody has cluttered themselves in a shell or something. But I understand that when you don't open up, you don't connect. And when you don't connect, people won't listen to you.
That's so true. Absolutely
true. So I have
true.
Broken that shell for myself.
Thank you for doing that for us also. Okay, That's Neha. Fun. Yes, tell me.
Okay, so I'm mostly in scarcity part rather than abundance currently. But I'm working more of the things like I have seen failure in my life because in last quarter I have given CFA level 1 and I didn't clear it for the first attempt but I'm attempting it for the second time and I will clear it but sometimes the thought goes in mind like why should me like I have never seen failure before and suddenly it comes but okay it's fine you don't have to give up every time you have to just give a second chance also
that's so. True and thank you for being so honest huh, Neha thank you for saying that most of the time you have been in there but and this is the fact you know most of us have been there especially with in the age group that you are right now you know it is very difficult to get in the abundance mindset with all the peer pressure that we have and you know everything happening around us it is so difficult we are always competing with people mujhe zyada mil jaye log mujhe dekhe you know we all want that opportunity koi mujhe nahi dekh raha use dekh raha and you know we are looking for admiration and appreciation I was so like this you know and all the women sorry girls that time they used to be so jealous of me and they used to be like I was pretty on that time also so that time also just imagine so I had a good fan following that time and these girls never used to talk to me too much now they are very good friends with me huh? They are really very good they are appreciative of the work that I am doing however all, during the school time it was you know most of the times it used to be the boys who used to be my friends because girls were like ye itna kyun bolti hai ye aise kyun karti hai and all of that and it happens
Same case so, with me.
So yes so that is the reason but then I tell you what this is what makes us what we are and this is why we all are here and not other girls are here okay they will not come join us here
Satya
and sorry no Satya is a cool guy now
and we in the middle in video is also in the middle in
the yes Satya what is your take on this
take see whatever these guys are saying it was like 10 years in my CA what are you saying I've been through everything like failures everything but one thing I learned was expectation you have to remove your expectations yeah see that's a thin line of difference between your actions and your expectations see we visualize things right when we are moving towards our goal we visualize the thing it is okay to achieve that but if you attach expectation like okay I need to see like I'll say you my example I'll just connect you why I learned this see I wanted to be an all India topper I just kept working on it the pressure started increasing like when you put lot of expectation, the pressure goes up. Like you saw 3 Idiots, right? I think all of you have watched 3 Idiots. The more the pressure that you have, you will not be able to concentrate on things. Like, okay, in future I have to do this, in future I have to do this, I have to be like this. But just if you remove your expectation, automatically your 95% of your mind become free. Literally, I'm stating.
Yes, yes, yes. That's totally
for sure. Next, failures. If you see, failures taught me 3 things. First thing, failures made me believe in myself. It made me understand what is belief, what is faith, what is hope, everything. Next, it taught me, see, in failures only we put all of our effort and give our best. If you can connect with this, I'm sure about this. If when we fail, no, I'm not saying in the pessimistic sense, but the other angle of failures I'm just trying to share. Don't mistake me. If you see, we will put all our efforts. That the failures bring the best out of us, and we will be disciplined and we stay humble.
That's true.
That's what I learned all these years, and I'm able to relate, but only from picture, like the first mindset, we go to the abundance. The scarce mindset, we can go to the abundance. But without that scarce, you cannot move to the abundance. But you know, right, you need to go to that last pinch point. Like you need to travel to the last point where, okay, more than this, I have nothing to lose. Then only you can go to that abundance. But it takes time.
No, it's not necessary. It is not necessary at all. Absolutely, but you do not have to, you know, lose so much then only, you know, when I will lose everything, then only I will you know, go and change myself. That is not necessary and that is not important. Failure is what we all face, and we all will be facing further in our life also. Till the end of our life, we will be failing and succeeding. This is a part and pass. Anyways, let's move on to Mansi. Yes, Mansi.
Okay, hello everyone. And it's my first day here. I'm very excited to share my opinions and everybody. I love everybody, what everybody said. Okay, what I think, the thing with me is like, I'm a very big overthinker. I overthink a lot about every small thing. Even taking example of your session, I attended the session which you took yesterday, what employers want. I've attended it before. And I gave it like a second thought. I thought for like a lot of times, should I invest money? How do I, you know, how I'm going to manage with it and everything? And I was very confused. I took opinions of my friends, of my cousins, my parents, that what do I want to do? But at the end of day, it was my decision to come here. So I'm very glad that I took it and I just don't regret it at all. Thank you so much. Secondly, I just want to share my experience that I recently got a job in an institute to teach French. So I went for interviews, and the thing with me is that I cannot handle failures at all. That's a very big problem with me. So so one of the interviewer, he told me that you're very good at your work, but I can't select you. So that's the one thing that hit me very bad was like, I couldn't get a proper answer from him. Like, if there's something lacking in me, I should know about it. And the thing that he told me, I was very upset with that fact that, you know, how do I deal with it? And I don't know what I'm going to do next. So I think it's very difficult for me to take failures and, you know, like move ahead. So that is where I lack upon.
We'll work on it just in the next whatever little part that is left. Yeah, Tanvi, tell me.
I want to share that I saved my money for the makeup I was going to buy with the course. But then your course appeared and I have to switch my mind.
No, that is very important thing for which you are saving money. I am liking that. Always do that, you know, for whatever makeup was left with me, I couldn't manage until this time, you know, till the lockdown is over and I could get hold of more of that. Sometimes, you know, saving is important. By saying that you come from scarcity mindset, I do not mean to say that, you know, you do not have to. Abundance people never save anything. That is not the fact. Okay, they also save. However, they do not fear losing things. You know, what if I lose this money? Then what will I do? And people who keep hoarding things and all of that, you know, that is different. So I think we are done with all of us. Yeah.
Yes.
So let's move and see now how can we actually change it. You know, how to change, how to shift from the scarcity mindset if at all we want to, okay? So there are a lot of things that we need to focus, okay? So focus on number one, maximizing your strengths, okay? I have repeatedly said this in the whole course because I am such a believer in strengths. I am passionate about talking about strengths, my own self and others also, okay? And I have this knack of, you know, finding strengths in people. You know, even I'll just share a very quick anecdote here. There was this instance. My mother always used to share this with me, to find good in every person. Okay, so she used to tell me this story that once it so happened that there were, you know, Krishna was there with his friends and they were roaming around here and there. And there was this very ugly looking dog who was barking, okay? And everybody felt disgusted looking at this dog, all Krishna's friends, okay? And then Krishna was calm and quiet, not just because he's God, but otherwise also he is a different person, okay? So that dog was literally, I mean, when my mother described the whole, you know, physical appearance of that dog, it was like, it felt disgusting only. However, Krishna said that, you know, can you just look at the teeth of these dog? Such shiny, bright, beautiful white teeth he has got. So the thing is that there is always something good in the worst of the person also. Okay, and we are not worst, we are not bad, we are good people. So when we are good people, of course we have our unique strengths, and this exactly is what we are going to, what is going to take us ahead. Okay, so when you are in scarcity, you think you do not have enough, you are not good enough. So abundant people, I am good for everything, I have it in myself. Okay, so they focus more on their strengths. Okay, then they focus on showing gratitude. As I said, there is, you know, the world will literally, you know, turn 360 degree for you if you will start showing gratitude. Day in, day night, before sleeping, after getting up, afternoon, evening, whatever, all the time. Show gratitude to people who are helping you, to your parents, to your siblings, to nature, to the five elements of space and everything that you have. Very, very important thing, okay? Then focus on achievement. So when you see... Mansi, your face was there, name was not coming. So when Mansi says that I cannot take failure, you know, there I can resonate with this. You know, I was also, you know, somehow I used to feel bad or rejected, and you know, how can I fail? This was the attitude with which I always had. You know, how can somebody say no to me? You cannot dare say that to me. I will win, I will always have this. Okay, that was sometime, you know, when I was probably your age, that was something that I also suffered with. However, when this is the feeling that you are getting, then you have to go back on something which you achieved in the past. Okay, so failures are going to be a part and parcel of it, because other people are also doing, no? And especially when in the interview scenario, people are not rejecting you because you are not good enough. They are rejecting you because what they are looking for is probably not there in you. You have a lot of things, but what they are looking is not matching with what you have. Okay, so there is no point reject. And then, you know, when people reject us, it gives us an opportunity to look back, think back and reflect upon our own self and see what is it that is missing, which I need to really work upon. Okay, so that is an opportunity that people are giving us, and we should rather be thankful to them. Okay, thank you for rejecting me. Now I am going to improve myself. If you get selected, then you will never know that you are missing something. Now people are giving you the opportunity to know what you are missing. Okay, and if they are not giving you feedback, go ahead and ask the feedback. What is it that you think would have made me right for this job? What is that one thing that you think I am missing? And there is no problem in asking that, you know. And when you communicate nicely and when you connect with people nicely, they would love to do that. If not, then maybe later through a mail or a text or a message, whatever way. Okay, but feedbacks are important. Then focus on environment. What I mean by environment is not just the environment, it is environment which is created by the people around us. If you think that you are amongst those people who are pulling you down, who are negative people, who are not thinking about growth mindset, who are not thinking about future, or you are not thinking about, you know, they are cribbing, crying, blaming other people. If you are surrounded by those people, I tell you what, no matter how good a mindset, how strong a mindset you have, you will get drawn with them. Okay, you will not be able to sail through. So what you have to do is you have to keep a check on your environment also. Be in a place, be with people, be with friends, be with mentors or whatever you have, you know. People who create that environment should be having that right mindset, okay, so that they can take you up, not pull you down, okay. Then focus on what you love. This is the favorite thing that I say. We love so many things, you know. And every time when you think you are not good enough, you're not doing good enough, then just shift that focus to what you love. When you are focusing on what you love, you are happy that, you know, the happy hormones are generating and your brain starts working better. Then focus on passion and purpose. I always say we all have to come to understand what is the purpose of life. I know I am almost close to double your age. 1.5 of your age, okay? 15 years at least, 15, 20 years elder to you. So this is the time, you know, I have come to know about my purpose very recently only, okay? And now I'm crazy about this. So I cannot expect you to have it forever. So, and purpose and passion, everything is going to evolve with time. Today, probably you have something in your life. You have set a particular purpose. Tomorrow, maybe when you learn something new, when you are exposed to other things, then your purpose might change, okay? But then today also, you have to go for something. There should be something that you want to achieve. There should be some people you want to help. There should be some problem that you want to really help solve. So purpose is important for us to identify. If any of you, once you are done with the 3-day videos, if you still find problem in finding your niche and identifying your purpose, we are going to have another mastermind and we'll help each other do that. Okay. Then focus on goals. Why I say that you need to set goals. See, it is okay. As Satya said, it is, you know, sometimes you set high goals and you do not achieve them and there is a lot of pressure. I totally get what he's saying, okay? However, when you if you do not do that also, then there is nothing to look forward to. And that is why setting goals is important. But once you have set the goal, and then in the next session probably, I'll teach you how to set SMART goals, okay? So when you are setting goals, you have to also understand that you have to know yourself first. Why I focus so much on, you know, first of all, you discovering what you are. That is so important because you will know that if this is a particular goal that I'm setting, whether I'm really ready for that kind of a goal. Do I have the skill set, the knowledge, the expertise to achieve that? Or whatever time period I have given, if I think, you know, I should be now, I know everything. Sakshi has said that if you just change your mindset, everything is going to be okay. And so fine, I have decided that from next month onwards, I should be earning 1 lakh rupees. Right now, you are not earning anything, okay? So that is like, that is a weird thing to do, fine? So you have to have everything and you need to know what should be the right goal for yourself. And then, you know, create that small, tiny, small goals to achieve that action steps that you need to work upon so that you accumulate that and then you finally reach your goal. Then you have to focus on growth. Growth again is the growth mindset. Okay, you do not have to think back up about what has happened. Has happened. It is what 3:58 right now. Okay, 3 o'clock I started the session. Yahan ye wala yaad rakhna hai aapko. So before 3 o'clock, what has happened in your life, which is past? Okay, it is okay. That has happened. That has to happen. Now what? So we are always, we as leaders in this community, outside this community, in the workplace, in the social space, we are always going to think about what is there in the present and what will be there in the future. We are not going to discuss the past. What has happened has happened. I have no control on that, but I will take lessons from that and I will think about what can I do better. Okay, so that is getting into the growth mindset. I am always growing. So basically, if you are not learning something new every day, every time, you are not growing. If you are not growing, what is happening? You are literally dying. Okay, so people who are not growing, suppose there is this plant. I love this plant. This is my favorite bamboo plant. Okay, and I'm working like this bamboo. Okay, I'm just going deep and deep and deep. And I don't know, someday I'm just expecting to shoot up like this. Okay, so if I do not water it, if I do not take care of it, what will happen? It is not going to grow. When things are not growing, that means they are no more breathing. Okay, so they are basically dying. So we all do not want to get into that space at all. Okay, until the day that is decided for us. So we have to actually keep on growing and learning every day. Then this is very important. Focus on becoming a beginner. Why I am saying this? And this is important for you, Shreya. Okay, I don't know anything. I am coaching you guys. Okay. I call myself career branding expert, career branding coach. However, every day I see that, you know, there is so much in my life that I have no idea about. I am always a beginner. I will always remain a student. I will never have enough learnings in my life so that I can just go back and learn and learn and learn. Okay, so I am not here to portray in front of you that, you know what, I am a coach. Okay, you guys need to listen to me. I do not have that attitude. I do not want any of us to have that attitude. Never, ever, ever would you ever see me saying that, you know, if I'm saying this, this is correct and you need to follow it. Okay, so when you guys send me your posts also, okay, several of us do this, yeah, Neha and Tanvi and Catherine, what do? We discuss the post that we share, right? And what I do I ever say to you that, you know, this is wrong, delete this, and this is right, add this? What I say, I suggest you something, okay? So this is my suggestion. So today Catherine has posted something on food, right? Food day today. What is it?
Food safety day.
So I said, no, you do not have to post anything on Sunday. And she said, ma'am, but today is food safety day. I said, sorry, I didn't know. Please go ahead and do that. Okay. So there are things that I do not know. Okay. And I will never say that I'm an expert in something, because I am an expert in certain thing with the respect that, you know, there are things that you do not know so far. Okay. Once you know, then you are at the same level. We are always at the same level. Okay. But in order for me to teach you something, I have to keep my level one up. Okay. Always. I should be knowing little extra so that you come to me and listen to what I have to say. Okay. So I always have to be what? A beginner. Some place or the other, I always have to be a beginner. I will never, ever, ever say that I'm an expert in something. Although I always say that we all have to become expert. Okay. But this is, just to tell you that you have to keep learning so that you get the expertise. Okay. But inside, we all will always think that I am a beginner. I am just starting. Okay, you see all these amazing singers and dancers and writers and authors, they always say, what is it? They are so humble and grounded people. They always say, I do not know anything. There is so much more to learn, you know. So my elder one, he's a pianist. He plays piano. He loves playing piano. And he is like, you know, and he doesn't practice. He is a wonderful singer also. He learns vocal, Hindi classical, okay? And he doesn't practice, but because he is naturally very talented, so he performs better. But I always say that, you know, and he has his ideals, okay? And so he says, bolo thodi na kuch practice karte honge. And I say, you know, Lata Mangeshkar does it today also. Sonu Nigam does it today also. And everybody whosoever is there on this planet who have achieved something, they have to stay in this position. So they have to practice. They have to keep doing it. Okay. So once and for all, let this seep into us that we will always be beginners. We will never show that we have got this thing. Okay. Yeah. So that is extremely important. Thand lag rahi hai mujhe. Shubhu, switch off the AC, please. So I just keep asking my, kids and husband to switch off the AC every now and then. Okay, so we have to maintain an attitude of openness and enthusiasm. Openness is something that Shreya has already shared with us. Okay, we will be open with each other. And, you know, transparency is important. Openness has a part of transparency also. So I have to be open to you. I do not have to hide anything from you. Whatever knowledge that I am getting from my coaches, I have different coaches for different things in my life. Okay, so everything that I am learning, I will be extremely transparent to sharing it with you guys, because I want you to raise your level. And there is a hidden, you know, selfish reason, because unless and until you rise here, nobody is going to look at me. Okay, your results are extremely important. So I have to give my heart, soul, everything to you people so that you guys succeed. And once you are there, it is going to be your responsibility, one, to stay over there, and then to prepare your mentees, okay, to bring up to that level. And every time we are going to raise our bar. Okay, so we all will have to maintain an openness and enthusiasm. Just be very, very open. At least in this community, we all can do that. Yeah. And then last is what is important. Focus on what is going right in our life. Okay. I tell you what is going right in my life. last month when I did not launch the product, this course, there was nobody, you know, and today we are 10 of us. Yeah, 9 of us at least. I mean, Shubhanshi is there, but she's right now not here. But then, see, had I not tried, had I not thought that, you know, someday I will have somebody, I would have not known such amazing people like you all, right? So what is going right in our life is what we have to focus on all the time. What has happened, what will happen. We do not care about that also. But every day we have to just take one small step ahead. Okay, so that is about the abundance mindset and everything. Yeah, now you guys want to ask me any question, then please do.